Hello dear students, welcome to online biology class. Let us move to the topic in the 11th PU biology syllabus. It is respiration in plants, and in this video I am explaining about the most important step in the respiration. It is glycolysis. So let us move to the details. As explained in the previous video, the respiration is of two types: aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, oxygen is not utilized, and in anaerobic respiration, oxygen is utilized, and in anaerobic respiration the oxygen is not utilized. So that aerobic respiration is characterized by complete oxidation of the glucose molecule, and in anaerobic respiration the glucose molecule is incompletely oxidized or partially oxidized. When glucose is completely oxidized, it produces more energy. When glucose is partially oxidized, the less energy is produced. But here I am going to explain the next process. Whether the respiration is aerobic or the respiration is anaerobic, both of them starts with a common step called glycolysis. So glycolysis is a common step observed in both aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. It is the common pathway. It is part of aerobic respiration as well as it is part of anaerobic respiration, because the glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm, where the glucose is oxidized into pyruvic acid. It is the complete reaction of glycolysis. What happens during glycolysis? The one molecule of glucose is partially oxidized into two molecules of pyruvic acid, and this is called glycolysis. Here, both the type of respiration, whether it is aerobic or it is anaerobic, eradu tharaddu respiration start agodu yava process inda athwa yava pathway dinda, glycolysis ano ondu pathway dinda. Glycolysis ige presence of oxygen or absence of oxygen doesn't matters. Oxygen present idrunu benefit illa, oxygen absent idrunu loss illa, because site of the glycolysis is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm olaga entire pathway nadithada, and glycolysis shuru agodu glucose molecule inda. Glycolysis end adaga alli en release aagtada, pyruvic acid molecules are liberated or pyruvic acid molecules are produced. So this is the first step and common step for both aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Then both of them, konege glycolysis the end product, aerobic respiration idra yelli participate maadutada, anaerobic respiration idra yelli participate maadutada, that is later decided. But for both the respiration, the common pathway is glycolysis. So now let us have a look on what happens to the pyruvic acid when it enters into aerobic respiration, and what happens to the pyruvic acid when it enters into anaerobic respiration. Because both the respiration processes starts with a common pathway called glycolysis, which is taking place in the cytoplasm. During glycolysis, glucose is converted into pyruvic acid. Remember, one molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid during the glycolysis pathway. ಬಂದಂಥ ಪೈರವಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಡು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅದ. ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತದ, ಆ್ಯನ್ ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತದ. ಬಟ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್, ನೋ ಡೌಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಲೈಸಿಸ್. The glycolysis is taking place in the cytoplasm. Glycolysis, the end product yavadada, pyruvic acid or pyruvate. That pyruvate enters into citric acid cycle or Krebs cycle. Then finally it enters into electron transport chain. And the point to remember is that both of them are occurring in the mitochondria. Aerobic respiration konege end agode mitochondria valaga. That is why the site of aerobic respiration is nothing but mitochondria. So ultimately, when the respiration is aerobic, the end product of the glycolysis, what is the end product of glycolysis? It is pyruvic acid, and that pyruvic acid enters into citric acid cycle and then it participates in the electron transport chain. So let me mark here the site of glycolysis is cytoplasm. So when the glycolysis is completed in the cytoplasm, what is the product and end product of glycolysis? Let us mark it. The end product of glycolysis is nothing but pyruvic acid or pyruvate. Pyruvic acid or pyruvate. I will write once again because it is not that clear. So let me select one more color for the better representation so that it will be easy to understand. Okay. So glycolysis site is cytoplasm. The glycolysis is occurring in the cytoplasm. And end product of glycolysis is, the end product is pyruvate or pyruvic acid, both of them are same. So pyruvate molecule, if the respiration is aerobic respiration, this pyruvate, it enters into mitochondria. And in the mitochondria, it undergoes citric acid cycle, or it is also known as Krebs cycle with reference to its discoverer Hans Krebs. Hans Krebs ano vidnyani idanna kandu hiditara. So Krebs cycle lige citric acid cycle antano karitara athwa Krebs cycle antano karitara. Then it undergoes electron transport chain. When entire process is completed, at the end of aerobic respiration, there is formation of 38 molecules of ATP. Very high amount of energy is produced during aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration also begins with glycolysis. Site of the glycolysis is cytoplasm. End product of the glycolysis is pyruvate. Cytoplasm olag iddantha pyruvate ellige move aagtada, mitochondria ku serkotada, and in the mitochondria first it undergoes citric acid cycle, which is also known as Krebs cycle, and finally it enters into electron transport chain. Therefore what are the steps during aerobic respiration? ನಾವು ಬರೀ ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡೋದಾದರೆ, ದ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ Aerobic respiration are, what are the different steps occurring during aerobic respiration? First one is glycolysis, common step for aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Then second one is citric acid cycle or Krebs cycle, and third one is electron transport chain. And when these three are completed, there will be synthesis of 38 molecules of ATP. So this is about aerobic respiration. So moving to the anaerobic respiration, it is also starting with glycolysis, and end product of the glycolysis is once again here pyruvate. When the glycolysis is completed, what is produced? Pyruvate or pyruvic acid. Pyruvic acid, both are same. The pyruvic acid which is produced in the cytoplasm, that remains in the cytoplasm itself, because in anaerobic respiration, whichever structure is showing anaerobic respiration, the mitochondria are absent. No need of mitochondria. So mitochondria is concerned only with the aerobic respiration. So aerobic respiration agovalle mitochondria beke beku, anaerobic respiration agovalle mitochondria is not at all necessary needed. So finally pyruvate en aagthad annodu depend aagthad process mele. Pyruvate may be converted into ethyl alcohol, alcoholic fermentation, or it may be converted into organic acid, lactic acid fermentation. Either it will produce ethyl alcohol or it will produce organic acid. And after anaerobic respiration, how many molecules of ATP are generated? Only 2 ATP molecules are produced. Look at the difference between aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration valaga 38 molecules of ATP generate aagtava, anaerobic respiration valaga just 2 molecules generate aagtava, because aerobic respiration is characterized by complete oxidation of substrate. Due to the involvement of oxygen, the substrate molecule is completely oxidized and it produces totally 38 molecules of ATP. But in case of anaerobic respiration, as the oxygen molecule is not involved, the only 2 ATP molecules are generated, and incomplete oxidation or partial oxidation of the glucose occur. The pyruvate which is produced in the cytoplasm, in the cytoplasm only, either it is converted into ethyl alcohol or it is converted into organic acid. So this is about the introduction or initial information about aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So now I'm going to explain the common pathway for aerobic and anaerobic respiration, and it is EMP pathway. So glycolysis is also known as or also called EMP pathway, and during glycolysis, partial oxidation or breakdown of glucose molecule occur into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid in the absence of oxygen, because cytoplasm oxygen nanna use maadkolalla alle oxygen na adike helide. Presence or absence of oxygen doesn't matter for the glycolysis. That is why it is a common step of respiration during both the aerobic and anaerobic respiration. What happens during glycolysis? Glucose molecule, how many? Only one. One cycle ge one glucose molecule. One molecule of glucose is converted or partially broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid in the absence of oxygen, and that process is called glycolysis. And the site of the glycolysis, you need to remember, it is cytoplasm. The site of the glycolysis is cytoplasm, and it is also known as EMP pathway. So these three biologists discovered the EMP pathway. Our letter galanna, our hesarinolagiro letter galanne idakke use maartara. E for Embedon, M for Otto Meyerhoff, M is considered, and P for Parnas. These three biologists discovered the schematic representation or scheme of glycolysis, hence it is also known as EMP pathway. In anaerobes, it is the only process of respiration. What are anaerobes? The organism which shows anaerobic respiration, it is called anaerobe. Yav organism anaerobic respiration exhibit maadutada avuka anaerobes anta karitara. Anaerobes olaga respiration olaga yavadare step nadithada andre it is only glycolysis. But in aerobes, that means organism which respire through aerobic respiration, alle first step is glycolysis, second step is Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle, and third step is electron transport chain. So more step olaga respiration complete aagutada, but anaerobes olaga only one step of the respiration which is represented is nothing but glycolysis. So during glycolysis, one molecule of glucose is partially broken down. Yak partial anta helbeku, because oxygen involvement is absent. Oxygen irangla anta helikattilla, mitochondria olage irutada, but cytoplasm ige oxygen involve agoden bekagilla. So in the absence of oxygen, glucose molecule is partially oxidized into two molecules of pyruvic acid. It is called glycolysis. And one more point to remember is site of the glycolysis is cytoplasm, and glycolysis is also known as EMP pathway. E for Embedon, M for Meyerhoff, and P for Parnas. These three biologists discovered the scheme of glycolysis, and it is also known as EMP pathway. So let us move to the details of glycolysis, how it is taking place. So in plants, glucose is derived from sucrose. What is that sucrose? It is end product of photosynthesis, and from storage carbohydrates. Whatever the starch is synthesized, sucrose is synthesized, from that plants will get the glucose. So glucose is monosaccharide and sucrose is polysaccharide, sorry, sucrose is disaccharide. Andre eradu carbohydrate molecule monosaccharide idrolu kudirthava, a sucrose dinda glucose anna derive madkotada. Then how this sucrose is produced? It is the product of photosynthesis. Sucrose is then converted into one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose by enzyme called invertase. And these two monosaccharides readily enter into the glycolytic pathway. What it means? One molecule of sucrose na break maadidre, sucrose is a disaccharide. When two monosaccharide units are joined by the glycosidic bond, the resultant carbohydrate is called the disaccharide. Sucrose is a disaccharide. ಇದು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ಸು. ಈ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸನ್ನ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟೇಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಎನ್ಝೈಮು ಬ್ರೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟೇಸ್ ದ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್ ಡೌನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಂಟು ಆರ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್ ಡೌನ್ ಇಂಟು ಒನ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್. ಒನ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಒನ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಡಿ ಇರ್ತವೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕೆ? ದೇ ಆರ್ ರೆಡಿ ಟು ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಪಾಥ್ವೇ. ದೀಸ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗೋ ದ ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಲೈಸಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟೇಸ್. ದೆನ್ glucose and fructose are phosphorylated. glucose and fructose are phosphorylated. ee term bandittu phosphorylation means addition of the phosphate. photophosphorylation andre photosynthesis olag nadithada. here I am talking only about phosphorylation, then simply addition of the inorganic phosphate. ಬೋಧ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸು ಮತ್ತು ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸು ಎರಡಕ್ಕೂ ಇನಾರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೋರಿಲೇಷನ್. ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹೆಕ್ಸೋಕೈನೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಐಸೋಮರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್. ಮೊದಲು ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಬ್ರೆಕ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಯಾವ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಲೇ? ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟೇಸ್. ನೌ ಬೋತ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೋರಿಲೇಷನ್. ಇನಾರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಡೆಡ್. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಬಂತು? ಇನಾರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ that phosphate is added from the ATP. it is energy consuming step in the glycolysis. conversion of glucose into glucose 6 phosphate, it requires energy in the form of ATP. the reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme hexokinase and ATP is converted into ADP. so ille ATP molecule iddiddu ಏನಾಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದ? ಎ ಡಿ ಪಿ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿನ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತದ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ. ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ? ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸಿಗೆ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್. ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ ಒಳಗಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ಹೊಯ್ತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಜನರೇಟೆಡ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಡಿ ಪಿ. ನೀವು ಯಾವ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಎರೋ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀರಿ ಆ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಶೋ ದ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಎರೋ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ಲೆಸ್. ಎ ಡಿ ಪಿನ ಎ ಟಿ ಪಿ ಆಗಿ ತೋರಿಸೋ ಹಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ATP is converted into ADP. from ATP one phosphate is added to glucose molecule so that glucose is converted into glucose 6 phosphate. andre carbon atom 6th carbon atom ige phosphate attach agedu anta artha. then with the help of another enzyme called isomerase. isomerase is another enzyme which converts ಫ್ರುಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟನ್ನು ಅದು ಏನಾಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ? ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಲೈಸಿಸ್. ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್ ಡೌನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೊಲೆಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್. ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಪಾತ್ವೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೆಟಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟೇಸ್. ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪೇಟ್ with the help of addition of the inorganic phosphate from ATP into ATP is converted into ADP and glucose 6 phosphate is converted into fructose 6 phosphate with the help of an enzyme called isomerase. This is the enzyme converting glucose 6-phosphate into fructose 6-phosphate. So now let us study the complete schematic representation of glycolysis. Actually idan one by one straight aage haakbeku, but slide saakagodilla anthe heli ee reethi idanna represent maadiddu. Your responsibility is to make the practice of this schematic representation compulsorily, and it will be 5 mark question. So enen aagthada during glycolysis, let us study the glycolysis step by step. So totally glycolysis includes 10 steps under the control of different enzymes. Idi glycolysis anna 10 steps olaga divide maartada, 10 step galanna, all the steps of glycolysis are catalyzed and controlled by different enzymes. So let us move to the details. Ellelli molecule ATP consume aitu andre energy consume aitu, ellelli energy liberate aglikattada, let us concentrate on the steps of glycolysis. As explained before, the glycolysis is initiated by glucose molecule. Here glucose is a 6-carbon compound, and this glucose with the help of enzyme hexokinase, using the ATP molecule, it is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. And as the ATP molecule is used, inorganic phosphate of ATP is added to glucose, and glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate, ATP is converted into ADP. So in this particular step, this is the first step, and here energy is utilized. ADP iddiddu ATP aagi convert aadre energy synthesize aadanga, ATP iddiddu ADP aagi convert aadre energy utilize aadanga. And what you need to remember, it is also 6-carbon compound. Glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate with the help of ATP, and ATP is converted into ADP. Then with the help of isomerase, glucose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 6-phosphate. It is also 6-carbon compound. See, fructose 6-phosphate, RNA carbon nige vande vandu phosphate group attach agada. Once again, the fructose 6-phosphate undergoes phosphorylation. It combines with the ATP. One more phosphate group is added to fructose 6-phosphate, and ATP is converted into ADP, and fructose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6-biphosphate. Munche vande phosphate group itto, iga mattondu sari phosphorylation ageda, mattondu ATP molecule iddu ADP ageda. ATP olagind phosphate fructose the first carbon ig attach aitu, so that molecule is fructose 1,6-biphosphate. From glucose molecule till its conversion into fructose 1,6-biphosphate, during these steps of glycolysis, two ATP molecules are used. One during the conversion of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate, another during the conversion of fructose 6-phosphate into fructose 1,6-biphosphate. Look at the number of carbon atoms. Glucose is a 6-carbon atom, 6-carbon molecule. Then glucose 6-phosphate also contains a 6-carbon. Then fructose is also having 6, and fructose 1,6-biphosphate also contains 6-carbon atoms. Now this molecule undergoes cleavage. Why this splitting is called cleavage? It is equal splitting. Fructose 1,6-biphosphate is broken into two molecules of 3-carbon compound. How many carbon atoms are there here? 6. E 6 carbon irodo yared molecule aagi divide aagthada, yaredu molecule gadu 3-carbon compound ava equally divide aagthava, 3-3 carbon compound aagi, it is called triose phosphate. The name is PGAL. Phosphoglyceraldehyde athava glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Another is DHAP dihydroacetone phosphate. Both of them are the triose phosphate molecule because both of them contain 3 carbon atom. Equally divide agodrinda 6 carbon compound iddiddu erdu molecule of 3 carbon compound agi divide aagtada. Hence the process is known as cleavage and reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme aldolase. So please look at this arrow mark, interconvertible. PGAL can be converted into DHAP and DHAP can be converted into PGAL. Now listen to the explanation very carefully. One molecule of PGAL, when it enters into remaining steps of the glycolysis, from one PGAL, one pyruvic acid is produced. But here, DHAP is also converted into PGAL. That means how many PGAL are undergoing the glycolysis? One PGAL molecule direct participates and another PGAL molecule produced by the conversion of DHAP also undergo the rest of the glycolysis process. So therefore, two molecules of triose phosphate are participating in the rest of the glycolysis steps. That is why at the end we are going to get two pyruvic acid molecule. One by the direct conversion of PGAL, another due to the conversion of DHAP into PGAL. So two PGAL molecules are participating. At the end of the glycolysis, two pyruvic acid molecules are produced. So idr mundagade ella 2 2 anta mention madkot hogini yakille 2 barithada andre ondu PGAL lu direct agi produce agida and DHAP nu PGAL agi convert agi that also undergoes the glycolysis. So totally 2 PGAL molecules participate in the remaining steps of the glycolysis, so that here the 2 is mentioned. PGAL in the presence of NAD plus, it gets reduced to NADH. NADPH photosynthesis vala bari beku, illi bari NADH, and it is converted into 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. Phosphoglycerate iddiddu 1,3 third carbon ige phosphate, iga one carbon ige ond attach aagtada. And this is the 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. Two molecules are produced. It is also 3 carbon compound. Up to fructose 1,6-biphosphate from glucose, all these are the 6 carbon compounds. From PGAL up to the pyruvate, remaining molecules are 3 carbon compound. Now 1,3-biphosphoglycerate undergoes the removal of phosphate molecule. Phosphate molecule remove aagtada and that phosphate combines with ADP and ADP is converted into ATP. Look at the arrow mark. Illi nodri arrow mark. ATP inda bandu ADP kadege arrow mark torshidre ATP is converted into ADP. Andra phosphate molecule use aagyada anta artha. Ille ADP in the arrow mark ATP torslikatada andre ATP molecule synthesize agedanta artha. 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid is converted into 3-phosphoglyceric acid andre first carbon ig attach agiro phosphate release aagtada. It combines with the ADP and synthesizes the ATP molecule. Now 3-phosphoglyceric acid, it interchanges the phosphate group and it becomes 2-phosphoglycerate. Third carbon igiddu the phosphate group, second carbon ig hogtada and this is 2-phosphoglycerate. It is also 3 carbon compound. It removes one molecule of water. From 2-phosphoglycerate, a molecule of water is removed and it is converted into phosphoenol pyruvate, short form PEP. The same you have studied in the C4 pathway, PEP, phosphoenol pyruvate. The phosphoenol pyruvate in the matte phosphate group release after the it combines with the ADP and it produces ATP. Finally, phosphoenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvic acid, which is also 3-carbon compound, but 2 molecules of pyruvic acid are produced. The process started with 6-carbon compound and it is 1 molecule, and when it is completed, 2 molecules of 3-carbon compound are produced, known as pyruvic acid. Initial 2 step olaga 2 kade ATP molecule use agide, and konege mugita bandange when 1,3 biphosphoglyceric acid is converted into 3-phosphoglyceric acid, here ATP is generated. 2 molecules of 1,3 biphosphoglyceric acid are converted into 2 molecules of 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Andre, how many ATP are generated here? 2 molecules of ATP. The same thing is applied here also. Illu kuda eshtu molecules of ATP bartava? 2 molecules of ATP are generated. Illi eshtu use agiddu? Illi idu 2 produced, ikade 2 produced. Andre totally 4 ATP molecule. 2 ATP illi use agyava, minus 2 madidrunu innu 2 namage extra sigutava. And 2 molecules of PGAL, NAD plus is reduced to NADH. 1 molecule of NADH is equal to 3 molecules of ATP. Andre ATP kinanu jasti energy edrolagirtada NADH olagirtada. So 2 NADH andra eshtu ATP? 6 ATP. 6 ATP plus this one 2, 8 ATP, this 2, 10 ATP. 10 ATP molecules olaga 2 ATP minus madidrunu kuda 8 molecules of ATP profit aagthada, but direct aagi NADH bitto direct ATP molecules eshtu generate aagyavu antandre, here 2 ATP molecules and here 2 ATP molecules, so 4 ATP molecules are directly synthesized during glycolysis, and 2 NADH molecules are synthesized during glycolysis, and 2 ATP molecules are used during the glycolysis. It is your responsibility to make the practice of entire schematic representation of the glycolysis, and it is carrying 5 marks. So moving to last bit of the explanation. In the glycolysis, totally the 4 ATP molecules are generated. Avagle helade 2 molecules at the conversion of 1,3 biphosphoglycerate into 3-phosphoglycerate. Another 2 molecules at the conversion of phosphoenol pyruvate into pyruvic acid. 4 ATP molecules are directly synthesized from 1 glucose molecule during glycolysis. Andre direct ATP form olaga, not in another form. Na helide NADH antandre 1 molecule of NADH is equal to 3 molecule of ATP, but hang beda namaga. Direct ATP form olage eshtu synthesize agyavu antandre 4 molecule synthesize agyavu. Pyruvic acid or pyruvate is the key product of glycolysis, and its metabolic fate depends on cellular need. So glycolysis mugudaga yen bantu athava yen produce aitu antandre, answer is pyruvic acid, or it is also called pyruvate. Remember, how many ATP molecules are directly synthesized during glycolysis? 4 ATP molecules are directly synthesized. And munde ee pyruvic acid elli hogtada, it depends on cellular need and type of the respiration. Aerobic respiration idre pyruvic acid do Krebs cycle. Here I have shown with the schematic representation. So let me mark this one. pyruvate is the product of glycolysis. Yarad molecule of pyruvate bantu. Yel hogbekadu. Aerobic respiration idre cytoplasm inda pyruvic acid yel hogtada. Mitochondria na serkotada. There it participates in Krebs cycle and finally undergoes electron transport chain. But if the respiration is anaerobic, either it will participate in the alcoholic fermentation or it will participate in lactic acid fermentation. Remember, the pyruvic acid is produced in the cytoplasm because the site of the glycolysis is a cytoplasm. A cytoplasm molagi yarad molecule of pyruvic acid produce aktava when one molecule of glucose is stepwise broken down in the cytoplasm. Two molecules of pyruvic acid are produced. This pyruvic acid is cytoplasm nage ulibeko athwa adu mitochondria ku hogbeko adu cellular respiration nu decide maadutada. If the respiration is aerobic, aglene heladange the pyruvic acid enter into aerobic respiration, it undergoes Krebs cycle. ಇಲ್ಲ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಆನೇರೋಬಿಕ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ ಪೈರವೇಟು ಅಥವಾ ಪೈರವಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಡು ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ನಾಗೆ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂತದ ಐದರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್. ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್, ಪೈರವಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮೈಟೋಕಾಂಡ್ರಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋಸ್ ಕ್ರೆಬ್ಸ್ ಸೈಕಲ್. Anaerobic respiration, pyruvic acid remains in the cytoplasm and either it will be subjected to lactic acid fermentation or it will undergo alcoholic fermentation. So totally 4 ATP molecules galu direct aagi generate aagtava nenpitkobeku. Initial 2 step olage during the glycolysis the ATP molecule are converted into ADP. One during the conversion of glucose into glucose 6 phosphate. Another during the conversion of fructose 6 phosphate into fructose 1,6 biphosphate. So this is about the glycolysis and remember this is very important bit of the chapter. Try to concentrate on the explanation as well as you make the practice of this schematic representation. Hope the explained part is clear for you. Thank you.